Hello indie game lovers, nerds and nerdettes, my name is Feniks and this is Indie Game News. Today we look at base building and survival genre. Please take your time and stay focused for next few minutes. As always, you can find all the relevant links in the video description. Great, we are going to start with the updates of already released games. KeeperRL has been a guest on this channel a few times already. And once again, I am happy to announce that the game has received another huge update. Alpha 23 introduces some big changes to the core mechanics. The game will now tie the progress of your dungeon to your conquest. Mana is no longer generated in the library, but is now awarded for plundering and raiding enemy sites. Naturally, with such a big change, we'll see a lot of rebalancing changes to the cost of improvements. The game introduces new endless mode, in which the players can face incoming waves of enemies that respawn on the edges of the map rather than permanent sites. A part of that, we will see addition of new spell, changes to attributes, and some more items and rework formula for experience in combat. We'll see changes to AI behavior and improvement to graphical interface. We'll also see many bug fixes, tweaks and improvements. This is a very big update, and I suggest that you look in the link in the descriptions for more details. Oxygen Not Included once again shows that developers at Clay Entertainment know how to run the early access right. Oil Upgrade is the latest update to the game. We'll see the introduction of hydrocarbons such as crude oil and petroleum, as well as plastics. The game introduces new oil biome and the oil geysers, which you can tap into to extract precious resource. Oil can be processed to provide you with power via petroleum generators and a new tier of materials via plastics. The new addition of suit mechanics allows you to control exactly in which areas your duplicants must wear protective equipment. New suits will protect your minions from temperature, toxic gases and other conditions, but come at the cost of reduced speed. Finally, the game introduces concepts of rooms. Now, when the area meets the requirements, it will become the specialized room that provides your people with benefits. For example, area with toilet, sink and a door is now recognized as a bathroom, and having all those things nearby together works better than having all the components separately. You may want to specialize the parts of your base that way. Month after my early access monitor video, the Astroneer brings you new content to the game. Coincidence? I let you decide. Seriously though, excavation update is quite a big update and is desperately needed by fans. Update includes new modules and items to craft. We'll see addition of canisters that for now will store collected soil, and in the future will be used to store all the liquids in the game. Developers added new mineral extractor module. It is used to extract resources from the terrain underneath your feet. We'll see also other modules and augments for your tools. Update also includes some crucial fixes to the vehicles and tweaks to research RGN ahead of research 2.0 changes. Developers also change how the power system works. Deforming, flattening and removing terrain is now free. Backpack, however, no longer sells charges. And once you run out, you are out until you can recharge at the base. Augments will also draw more power when activated. In addition, we'll see many more minor changes to the game, tweaks and bug fixes. Let's hope that this update will be the first of many big changes and we'll see development speeding up. Novus Inceptio has seen the Halloween update bringing us new UI to the game. The brand new character window allows you to find lots of information and especially passive bonuses. These passive bonuses influence behavior of the game, reducing the production time, gathering better items, etc. Passive bonuses value stack, so the more bonuses you have, the stronger the benefits. The new UI allows you to better see your stats and attributes, provides you with better information and makes it easier to activate skills. If you never heard of Novus Inceptio, here is some basic info. It is a survival base building game set on the Earth in the far future. Human race ended in the nuclear war, and millennia later, the race was recreated by the mysterious creators. You are the human 2.0 trying to make a living. The game features survival elements but aims to make them less tedious than most of the games in the genre, focusing more on exploration and base building aspects of the game. You have access to complex crafting system that places a lot of emphasis on material bonuses and components that allows you for creation of truly unique items. Character skills and attributes are adjusted as you use them, therefore they will adjust to your personal game style, making you better at the things you do more often. The game features a modular building system with the ability to plan your base prior to gathering resources. Finally, the game features aging of your character. As you age, you will get better and level up, but eventually you will face inevitable death. Fear not, however, because you will respawn as a future generation. Each generation is stronger than the previous one, thanks to generation points that you can spend to make your character stronger. The game has been in early access since October 2015 and received regular updates, and is currently sitting on 73% positive review score on Steam. Rise to Ruins is slowly heading towards the final release on Steam. Developers are looking at some time next year. However, we are promised that the final release doesn't mean the updates will stop. Developer assures the fans that the works will continue past the release for a long time. In the meantime, we can enjoy the quality of life update. Villagers will now age and die over time, but provide them with happy and healthy life can increase their lifespan. They will eventually retire from work at the old age, but in exchange, will impart their wisdom onto a new generation, providing XP boosts to the new generations. Looking after your eldest can help maintaining stable workforce. With the addition of this new social bar, villagers with a low social need will now seek others to spend the time with them. Having social needs not met will result in their unhappiness, while vibrant social life will result in happiness boosts. Housing is now changed as well. Rather than tents, shacks and hovels, you can now choose between the low occupancy and quick energy research and the high occupancy and low quality homes. It will be up to you to decide drawbacks and benefits depending on your personal style. We'll also see upgrades to farms. They will be much larger than what the players are used to, but as you level them up, they will provide you with much better yield and growth rate. Finally, we'll see upgradable storage system and storage management systems. You will be able to enable storage of certain items. You will also be able to choose between the catch-all smaller storage system and resource-specific larger storage buildings. Okay, time for recent releases. Ostriv Alpha 1 released via Humble Bundle and is now available to purchase via developer website. The game has received very positive reception, and there are few long series on YouTube already if you want to check it out. Vanilla PC Strategy and Catherine on Sky both have a great little series that showcase the game. Developer eventually plans to release on Steam, and those who buy on Humble Bundle will receive the Steam keys. Ostriv aims to raise the bar of city building experience by adding a huge amount of possibilities and removing annoying limitations. It allows for truly organic town layouts without the grid or angle restrictions and a three-dimensional landscape. The goal is to make the player's creations to become alive and believable communities, where the real life problems would arise, thus making late game a new challenge rather than repetitive chore. In this game, you become creator of Ukrainian village in the 18th century. Your job will be to provide your settlement with food, resources and trade. You will need to manage job market to ensure your villagers have enough money to afford the rent and goods. Game features realistic gender-specific jobs, appropriate for the era. We'll see advanced crop rotation, organic growth modeling, changing seasons, basic trading and over 25 buildings available in the current version of the game, with more to come in the future. Roadmap for a game looks impressive as well, with private businesses, in-depth training, animals, weather effects, education, religion, security and much more. Check the links in the description for more details. As always, we end the show with the announcements. The Colonist released their first trailer. The Colonist is a settlement building game inspired by classic titles like The Settlers and Anno series. You take control of the team of robots tasked with settling up the new discovered planet, preparing the ground for an influx of inhabitants from the homeworld. You will advance from the Stone Age to Space Age as you build the infrastructure for your colony by constructing complex roads, boats, trains and drone transportation system. Colonist will feature a single player campaign, a free play mode, competitive multiplayer and co-op. There is no official date yet, but according to developer, we should expect announcements very soon. Okay guys, that's it in this month Indie Game News. If you know of any other games that should be featured in the next month update or you release the game yourself, please contact me at writetofeniks@gmail.com or tweet to me at feniks_gaming. If you enjoyed this video, please don't forget to subscribe for more. Nerds and Nerdettes, my name is Feniks and it was a pleasure to have you here. Take care.